Christ Kids TV. Let's begin.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Let's pray.
We thank God for today, all of our food, everything we have. We thank Him to be with us, and we pray for people who are suffering in this world right now. And I pray for all you guys who are watching and the amazing people here in this world. Amen.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
And now it's time for the memory verse.
Hi, I'm four and my name is Caleb.
Hi, my name is Zach and I'm eight.
Let's do the memory verse.
Love the Lord
your God
with all your heart.
In all your soul,
in all your strength,
in all your mind,
and love your neighbor as yourself. Luke 10:27.
Let's do it again.
Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength, with all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself. Luke 10:27.
Bye. Bye.
Hey, what's going on? You doing all right?
Yeah. You look good.
Ah, thanks. You know, I got my stuff going here. It's great, you know?
Yeah.
It's great.
Yeah, you're looking really good.
I mean, that's pretty cool stuff, right?
Yeah.
You know, it's all. It's really. I mean, it's okay.
Well, what's going on?
Well, you know, like I've seen people. They've seen me. They know I got all this stuff.
Yes.
You know, and they're kind of like they used to say, "Hi, Matt," and now they just say, "Hi, Super Person." I mean, like that's all I'm kind of.
Well.
I can't. I kind of am. I kind of feel like I have to do this all the time.
But that's not who you are. Remember, like, these are just gifts you got at your baptism.
Wait, so you mean, like, so I'm still also Matt?
Yes. You are Matt, child of God.
So, like, if I, what happens if I take it off?
Nothing.
No way. I'm gonna see how this works here.
Let me just
shoot these guys over there, drop this down here, kick this guy off, here we go. And I'm gonna try my superpowers and they're not gonna work because I don't have those things. I still have all my superpowers!
Oh, that's awesome!
They're still within me! I was so worried that I was gonna have no superpowers and I could be Super Person and Matt at the same time!
That is awesome!
That's truly who I am. I feel so much better. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
You are a superhero all the time, and you are always, always, always a child of God.
So good. I'm glad we run into each other weekly.
Yes, it's so good.
It's so great.
High five.
High five.
Woo! Okay, see you later.
Yep. Do, 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 do.
Welcome to this week's Pastor Time. I have a secret that I've got to tell you, but you can't tell anybody else. I'm really Pastor Drew. I know you may not have recognized me. I have my disguise on today, but I'm really Pastor Drew. In fact, I'll show you here. There, that's better. Well, I was just kidding there, guys. I don't wear a disguise. I've never needed one. But isn't it true that a lot of superheroes do wear a disguise? Batman has to disguise himself as Bruce Wayne. Connor and Catboy or Wonder Woman. What about Jesus? Today in our gospel lesson, we're remembering that most days Jesus was a lot like an ordinary person. He looked on the outside like an ordinary guy who did ordinary things. But today in our gospel story, Jesus is going to reveal his true identity as the Son of God. His clothes will have a brilliant white about them, and God the Father is going to speak from heaven and say, "This is my beloved Son with whom I'm well pleased." The truth is, Jesus was the most powerful, amazing, strong person who ever lived. But Jesus didn't want people to follow him just because of those things. He wanted us to follow him because of his love. But on the Transfiguration, he shows us that he truly is the Son of God. That word transfiguration is a big word, isn't it? But what it really means is to change. Jesus is changed on the mountain for a moment, so we see his true identity. And you know what else is changing? Your heart and mine, as his Holy Spirit lives in us and shapes us to be like Jesus. You know, so often the superheroes, they have sidekicks, right? Who's Batman's sidekick? Robin, that's right. Wonder Woman has Wonder Girl, and even Catboy has Gecko and Owlette who partner with him. We're called to be like superheroes for God, to be sidekicks of Jesus as we do his work, as we serve in his name, as you share his love. And you know, it makes me think how I was given this cape years ago, and I don't normally wear this cape, but I'm going to put it on today because we're not to hide our true identity as superheroes of God, but to let his light so shine in us that others would see our good works and give glory to our Father in heaven. There, that's better. Guys, let your light shine. Put on your superhero cape. Don't disguise who you are as a follower of Jesus, but listen to him as you hear his gospel Bible story today, and then follow Jesus in the world as a superhero for God. God bless you guys this week, and we'll talk to you soon. Bye.
Oh.
If you are one of our older friends, skip to the timestamp below. If you are one of our younger friends, wait till the timer runs out to start your lesson.
Hey everyone, it's Miss Kate. Welcome to the fifth week of your superhero training. Last week we learned that God gave each and every one of us extra special powers. And God wants us to share our extra special powers with others, because when we do, we're also sharing God's love. Then we added our super mask to our superhero uniform so that we can see the possibilities or chances to use our powers to help and show love to others. So, did you use your extra special powers to help or show love to someone this week? Give me a thumbs up if you did. Awesome. Remember, when we use our extra special powers to love God and love others, we can make someone or something better than when we found it, which makes the world a better place. Today we're learning that God helps us discover our passion. Our passion is like our mission. It's what God created each of us to do. Jesus's mission was to show everyone God's love and to save the world. Over the last few weeks, we've seen Jesus show God's love in lots of amazing ways. And today, we're going to hear about when Jesus told three of his closest friends about his mission. Our story today is called The Transfiguration. Transfiguration is a big word that means to change or transform. Can you say it with me? Transfiguration. You got it. Jesus changed the way his friends could see him, so that they would know who Jesus really is. To his friends, Jesus just looked like a regular, normal person. But in our story today, Jesus shows his friends that he really is God's son, and that he has an important mission to complete. Jesus's friends, Peter, James, and John, see Jesus in a way that no one else on earth ever has before. Let's hear the story. Today we're reading from our Spark Bible. Our story is called The Transfiguration, and it starts on page 358. Peter, James, and John were very excited. They were climbing a mountain with Jesus. Higher and higher they climbed, right to the top. Then they noticed something was different about Jesus. Jesus's face and clothes were bright and shiny like the sun. Moses and the prophet Elijah were standing with Jesus, talking about God's promise to save the world. Peter couldn't believe his eyes. Look, Jesus is so bright and shiny that his friends are having to cover their eyes. Then suddenly, a cloud covered the mountain. A voice said, "This is my son. Listen to him." I wonder whose voice it was. What do you think? The voice was God. Peter, James, and John covered their faces. Then Jesus touched them. They peeked up. Everything was the same as it was before. Even Jesus. On the way back down the mountain, Jesus, Peter, James, and John talked about God's promise, but they didn't tell anyone else what happened on the mountain for a long time. Wow. So Peter, James, and John saw and heard amazing things on the mountain with Jesus. They saw Jesus turn bright and shiny, and they even heard God's voice. Jesus changed right in front of his friends, from his human form to his God form. And when Jesus did this, he revealed his true identity as God's son. You know, a lot of superheroes transform from one form to another. Let's see if our friend TV can help show us some examples. Oh, hey TV, it's good to see you. It's been a while. Thanks for joining us today. All right, who do you have for us first, TV? Look, it's Clark Kent. He looks like a regular businessman. He's got his suit and his glasses. Do you know who Clark Kent transforms into? That's right. Clark Kent transforms into Superman. Okay, TV, who do you have for us next? Oh, I know him. It's Peter Parker. He looks kind of just like a regular, totally average guy. Do you know who Peter Parker transforms into? Spider-Man. Okay, TV. Do you have one last superhero transformation for us? Oh, look, it's Bruce Wayne. Another businessman in a suit. Do you know who Bruce Wayne transforms into? It's Batman. Wow, thanks TV, that was really fun. Thanks for your help today. We'll see you later, bye. Okay, so there's a bunch of superheroes that transform or change the way that they look, kind of like we heard Jesus do in the story today. But you know what? There is one big difference. Superheroes like TV showed us, like Superman, Spider-Man, and Batman, they transform so they can hide who they really are. They want to keep their true identity a secret, but not Jesus. In our story, Jesus transformed so he could show who he really was. Jesus didn't want to keep his true identity a secret. Jesus wanted people to know who he really is and that he came to save the world. This is just another reason why Jesus is the ultimate superhero. Let's close in prayer and thank God for sending Jesus to be our example. At the end of the prayer, you'll hear me say, "And all God's children said," and after you hear me say those words, I want you to say amen with me. Okay? Let's bow our heads and put our hands together. Dear God, thank you for sending your son, Jesus. Help us to listen to Jesus and follow his example. And all God's children said, amen. All right, superheroes. Today we learned that God helps us discover our passion. Our passion is like our mission. It's what God created us to do. Jesus's mission was to show everyone God's love and to save the world. And our mission is to follow Jesus's example, to go out and tell others about God's amazing love and to share that love with other people. To help us remember this mission, we have one more piece to add to our superhero uniform. I'll be back in just a minute to tell you more. Have you ever noticed that lots of superheroes have big old emblems right here on their chest? Think about it. Superman has a big S, Spider-Man has a spider, and Batman has a bat. These emblems let everyone know who they are, but they also serve as a reminder to each superhero of their passion or mission. Since today is the last week of our superhero training, we need to make our emblems to show the world that we are superheroes for God and that we're ready to follow Jesus's example. So, I've got some craft supplies here that I found around my house, and I'm going to use them to make my superhero emblem. Let's see what I found. All right, I've got all different colors of construction paper, and I found some cool stamps. I've got different colored pens and markers and things like that, and something I definitely want to make sure I use is some of these really cool washi tapes. So, I'm gonna go and work on my superhero emblem, and I'll be back in a little bit to show you what I made. Okay, I'm back, and I'm so excited to show you the emblem that I made. I wanted to make it heart-shaped so that I always remember to show love in everything that I say and do. And if you look closely, you'll see that I even added extra heart stamps around the edge. Do you see what letter I put inside of my emblem? That's right, it's a K, which is the first letter of my name, Kate. I put this emblem over my heart because when I was baptized a really long time ago, God claimed me as one of his beloved children. And this reminds me of my baptism into God's family and helps me focus on carrying out our mission. Remember, our superhero training started with remembering our baptism and all the cool things that God gives us when we're baptized so that we can be prepared to be superheroes. Like our super shoes. They remind us that God has paved a special path for each one of us. And God has a plan for our lives and is always with us, guiding us down our path. And then we have our capes. And our capes wrap around our bodies and remind us how God's love is always wrapped around us. That way, we can always remember our purpose, to love God and love others. And we can't forget our super masks. Remember that they help us to look inside of ourselves so that we can see our extra special powers. And our mask also helps us to look out into the world to see possibilities or chances to use our powers. And when we use our powers to love God and love others, we make the world a better place. And today, we added our final piece of our superhero uniform. Our super emblem shows the world our true identity as a superhero for God and reminds us to share God's amazing love everywhere we go and in everything that we do. So now it's your turn to make your emblem. Go ahead and get whatever you have in your house. It can be felt, construction paper, really any material. Just be sure to put the first letter of your name somewhere on your emblem. And then you've got to add it to the rest of your superhero uniform. Now you're ready to be a superhero for God. Congratulations on your graduation from superhero training. Now it's time for you to go and carry out the mission of loving God and loving others. I'll see you next time. Bye.
Thanks for joining us this week on Christ Kids TV.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to our last session of superhero training. Over the last several weeks, we have been learning how to be superheroes for God. We've been learning that God has a path for us and God has a purpose for us, which is to love God and love others. And we learned that our words are super duper powerful. We've also learned about the amazing possibilities that our unique gifts can be used to love and serve God. So what's left to learn? Well, you know where we gotta go, right? Our Deep Blue Bibles. So go grab yours and read along with me. We are going to be reading from the Gospel of Mark, and it is chapter 9, verses 2 through 8. And it's on page 1121. Here we go. 6 days later, Jesus took Peter, James, and John and brought them to the top of a very high mountain where they were alone. He was transformed in front of them. They're talking about Jesus here. And his clothes were amazingly bright, brighter than if they had been bleached white. Ooh, that must be really, really bright. Elijah and Moses appeared and were talking with Jesus. Peter reacted to all of this by saying to Jesus, Rabbi, it's great that we're here. Let's make those three shrines, one for you and one for Moses and one for Elijah. He said this because he didn't know how to respond, and the three of them were terrified. Then a cloud overshadowed them, and a voice spoke from the cloud. This is my son, whom I dearly love. Listen to him. Suddenly, looking around, they no longer saw anyone with them except Jesus. So, two big things happening right there. First, Jesus is transformed right in front of their eyes, and he was glowing, which had to have been pretty awesome and pretty scary at the same time. Like, did you catch that part about how the disciples were terrified? Peter starts saying random stuff because they were all like freaking out and didn't know what else to say or do. You know, thinking about Jesus transforming like that makes me think about some of our superhero stuff. There's a lot of superheroes that change or transform from one identity to another. Hey, TV, can you come help me out with this, please? All right, TV, help me out. Show me a superhero who has their regular identity. Who have you got? Clark Kent. Nice. See, he just looks like a regular businessman. Like, he's got a suit, glasses, nothing special going on there. But you know who he transforms into? Let's see. Superman. That's right. All right. Who else have you got, TV? Oh, Peter Parker. He looks like a totally average guy and can't possibly transform into a superhero, right? Let's see. Spider-Man. All right. He becomes Spider-Man. Nice. All right. Last one, TV. What have you got for us? Bruce Wayne. You know what? He's another regular looking businessman. He could be living anywhere and no one would really know who he is. But who does Bruce Wayne transform into? Batman. All right, that's some good stuff. Thanks, TV, I appreciate your help. See you next time. Okay, let's get back to our lesson and the second big thing that happened in our gospel story today. The voice of God clearly speaks and tells the disciples, "This is my son, whom I dearly love. Listen to him." Do those words sound familiar to any of you? I'm pretty sure we heard those words like way, way back when we first started our superhero training by learning about baptism. Hang on, let me check. Let's see, go to the Bible, and let's see, we've been in the Gospel of Mark. Jesus baptized. Hey, okay, in Mark chapter 1, verse 11, it says right after Jesus was baptized, there was a voice from heaven that said, you are my son, whom I dearly love. Wow, we have come full circle in our superhero training. We learned about the superpowers that we receive in baptism and heard God telling us how much he loves Jesus. Well, now as we finish our training, we've learned that not only does God have this incredible love for Jesus, but he wants us to make sure that we listen to him too. Whew. All right, well now we have got one last thing to do to complete our superhero suits. So go get yours, put it on, and come right back.
All right, so we have our super shoes to help us walk on the path that God has laid out for us. We have our awesome capes to remind us that we are wrapped in God's love, and our purpose is to love God and love others. And we have our mask, and our mask helps us to focus and look at the possibilities in ourselves and in others for how we can use our gifts to love and serve God. There's one thing left that we need. You know what it is? An emblem. You know, Wonder Woman has the really cool W's. Batman has that really awesome looking bat. Want to know what my emblem is? Are you ready? Dun, da, da, da. It's a K.
Why is it a K, do you ask? Well, K is the first letter of my name, Kristen. So I put this K over my heart because when I was baptized a really, really long time ago, God claimed me as his beloved child. So having my name right over my heart reminds me of my baptism into God's family and helps me focus on carrying out our mission of loving God and loving others. Now I want you to get whatever you have in your house. It can be felt, it can be construction paper, any other material, and cut out the first letter of your first name for your emblem. Add it to your suit, and you are ready to be a superhero for God. Congratulations on your graduation from superhero training! It is time for you to go and carry out the mission of loving God and loving others. I gotta run. See you next time.
Thanks for joining us this week on Christ Kids TV.